years now. Medicine has saved my life. Today is a different day, an age where HIV is no longer listed as a terminal illness, but a chronic, manageable disease. I know 99% of my friends still look at me and probably ask themselves, how much longer am I gonna have? Or how sick am I gonna get? I am sure they all wonder, when will they ever just come to me? One on one and ask me directly about me. When? I have had arguments with my own father because it seems every single time I get my new blood work and have my numbers scrutinized by everyone, I have to re-educate my father on what the numbers mean. I have one current friend, one, who can actually tell the numbers to. And she knows what it means. I don't have to re-educate her each and every time. Now I know it is not my responsibility to do this for my benefit. I know it's not my responsibility, but for the benefit of you knowing me better. But you know what? This would help you also know your own body better. And hey, people, this is not a gay disease. Do you know that in 1994, when I was a student at the Ohio State University, they had tested 900 fraternity and sorority students for HIV and other STDs, and the results were shocking. 10% of those heterosexual students were tested HIV positive. That would be 90 students out of 900, or to give a very, very rough number, Ohio State is one of the country's largest universities, and if you have 50,000 students, and if 10% are HIV positive, that would be 5,000 students. If you are straight, hetero, or whatever you want to label yourself, you are not free from this disease. Your ignorance will infect you. Your ignorance will infect you. I hope I made myself clear. I will wrap this up now, because in all honesty, I can only discuss this for so long before it still remains heavy in my head. I know a lot about sex, people. I have done all I need to know what works for me. What I have learned at the age of 35 is that sex is easy. Intimacy is not.